I'm going to describe a technique that's used fairly extensively in heterogeneous catalysis for characterizing catalysts as well as studying reactions. And it's called temperature program desorption. What I want to do is describe it, and I'll solve the equations that describe the behavior we observe experimentally. So the idea is pretty simple. If we start out with some gas that's adsorbed on any surface, as we raise the temperature, that gas is going to desorb into the gas phase. And so what we want to do is study this desorption. And what we're going to do in temperature program desorption is measure the rate of desorption as a function of time or as a function of temperature. So the rate of desorption is going to be proportional to some pre-exponential factor, some exponential term containing an activation energy, and then we'll consider the case where it's proportional to the concentration. So this is first order desorption. It doesn't have to be first order, but we're going to look at the simple case. This is the rate, and this is the rate that in the actual experiment, we would plot the rate versus temperature as we raise the temperature. And so this is a surface concentration, not a gas phase concentration, but a surface concentration. And the E is the activation energy for desorption. And the activation energy for desorption is, in many cases, just equal to what's often referred to as the heat of adsorption, where this is a positive value. So this would be the same as minus delta H of adsorption, since adsorption is typically exothermic. So what happens as we raise the temperature? The most common way is a linear ramp, which means the derivative temperature, respect to time, is a constant. We're going to use beta to indicate this. So as we raise the temperature, we typically start at a low enough temperature that there's no desorption. So down here, we can wait without being concerned the molecule is desorbing at a significant rate. As we raise the temperature, the rate starts increasing exponentially because of this term. And then what's going to happen is it'll go through a maximum. And it's going to go through a maximum because we've desorbed enough. So this term is increasing as we raise the temperature. This term is decreasing. And eventually, this term dominates. The rate decreases. We get to the point where now everything has desorbed. And so this is what we would observe in a temperature program desorption experiment. The temperature increasing, we often measure this peak temperature as an indication of how strongly the molecule is adsorbed on the surface. Of course, that temperature depends on how fast we carry out the heating. So let's look at some just sample numbers as a way to determine exactly what this curve shape looks like. So I picked the rate of heating of 10 degrees per second. In an ultra-high vacuum system, this might be a reasonable rate. I'm going to start at 300 Kelvin, namely this point, 300 Kelvin. And I'm going to use a dimensionless surface concentration. We could certainly do it in terms of molecules per square centimeter. Tends to be large numbers. And so let's just do it dimensionless to make it easier to see the behavior. And essentially what I'm doing is solving two equations, a mass balance, change in concentration on the surface, respect to time, is equal to the rate of desorption, which of course has this exponential dependence on temperature, and we're using first order case, and the change in temperature, respect to time, is equal to beta. Then we're going to solve these equations simultaneously. We'll do this numerically because of this exponential term. We want to plot the change in the concentration of A with respect to time versus the temperature. This is what we refer to temperature program desorption. This would be what we typically plot. So what I'm going to do now is solve these two differential equations numerically. I've used Polymath, and I'll show you the program and the output. So on the left is a Polymath program with a number of comments of what we're doing, but basically we're solving two ordinary differential equations simultaneously, and then plotting the rate of desorption, that's what we measure experimentally, as a function of temperature. And what I'm showing in these three plots are for three starting concentrations. So in this case, I've used values of 100, 50, and 25. An important thing to notice is the curves look identical except scaled by their initial concentration. In other words, if I take this curve and multiply by 2, I get this curve. If I take this curve, multiply by 4, again, I get this curve. The peak temperature doesn't change for this first order process. By this point, of course, everything has desorbed. And this is, again, what we would measure experimentally as a way to characterize how strongly something is adsorbed on a surface. The area under these curves is proportional to how much is adsorbed on the surface initially. And so that's a brief description of temperature program desorption. Remember, this is for first order, and the second order behavior or zero order have different temperature dependence, but the idea is the same. We can certainly, with this same program, change to second order or zero order and observe what the behavior is.